Galliforms? What kind of birds are they? Are they chickens? Like, share and subscribe and ring the bell for more videos. Galliforms is an order of heavy-bodied ground-feeding birds that includes turkey, grouse, chicken, New World quail and Old World quail, ptarmigan, partridge, pheasant, francolin, jungle fowl and the Chrysidae. The name derives from gallus, Latin for cock or rooster. Common names are gamefowl or game birds, lamefowl, gallinaceous birds, or galliforms. Wildfowl or just fowl are also often used for the galliforms, but usually these terms also refer to waterfowl, anseriforms, and occasionally to other commonly hunted birds. This group has about 290 species, one or more of which are found in essentially every part of the world's continents, except for the innermost deserts and perpetual ice. They are rarer on islands, and in contrast to the closely related waterfowl, are essentially absent from oceanic islands, unless introduced there by humans. Several species have been domesticated during their long and extensive relationships with humans. This order contains five families, Phasianidae, including chicken, quail, partridges, pheasants, turkeys, peafowl and grouse, Odontophridae, New World quails, Numidae, Gynephal, Chrysidae, including Chacalacus and Curassows, and Megapodidae, incubator birds like mallee fowl and brush turkeys. They are important as seed dispersers and predators in the ecosystems they inhabit, and are often reared as game birds by humans for their meat and eggs and for recreational hunting. Many gallinaceous species are skilled runners and escape predators by running rather than flying. Males of most species are more colorful than the females. Males often have elaborate courtship behaviors that include strutting, fluffing of tail or head feathers, and vocal sounds. They are mainly non-migratory. Systematics and evolution. The living galliforms were once divided into seven or more families. Despite their distinctive appearance, grouse and turkeys probably do not warrant separation as families due to their recent origin from partridge or pheasant-like birds. The turkeys became larger after their ancestors colonized temperate and subtropical North America, where pheasant-sized competitors were absent. The ancestors of grouse, though, adapted to harsh climates and could thereby colonize subarctic regions. Consequently, the Phasianidae are expanded in current taxonomy to include the former Tetraonidae and Meleagridae as subfamilies. The anseriforms, waterfowl, and the galliforms together make up the Galloensere. They are basal among the living Neognathous birds, and normally follow the Paleognathae, Ratites and Tinamous, in modern bird classification systems. This was first proposed in the Sibley-Alquist taxonomy and has been the one major change of that proposed scheme that was almost universally adopted. However, the galliforms as they were traditionally delimited are called Gallimorphae in the Sibley-Alquist taxonomy, which splits the Chrysidae and Megapodidae as an order Crassiforms. This is not a natural group, however, but rather an erroneous result of the now obsolete phonetic methodology employed in the Sibley-Alquist taxonomy. Phonetic studies do not distinguish between plesiomorphic and epimorphic characters, which leads to basal lineages appearing as monophyletic groups. Historically, the button quails, Turnisidae, Mesites, Meseta Ornithidae, and the Hotsin, Opis Hocomus Hosin, were placed in the galliforms, too. The former are now known to be shorebirds adapted to an inland lifestyle, whereas the Mesites are probably closely related to pigeons and doves. The relationships of the Hotsin are entirely obscure, and it is usually treated as a monotypic order Opis Hocomiforms to signify this. The fossil record for the galliforms are incomplete. Evolution. Galliform-like birds were one of the main survivors of the K-T event that killed off the rest of the dinosaurs. The dominant birds of the era were the Enantiornithes, which had teeth and dominated the trees and skies, whereas the galliforms were a niche group that were toothless and ground-dwelling. When the asteroid impact killed off all non-avian dinosaurs, and the dominant birds, it destroyed all creatures that lived in trees and on open ground. The Enantiornithes were wiped out, but the ancestors of galliforms were small and lived in the ground or water which protected them from the blast and destruction. Fossils of these galliform-like birds originate in the late Cretaceous, most notably those of Ostenornis lentus. Its partial left tarsum to tarsus was found in the Austin Chalk near Fort McKinney, Texas, dating to about 85 million years ago, MIA. This bird was quite certainly closely related to Galliformes, but whether it was a part of these or belongs elsewhere in the little-known Galliform branch of Galloanthridae is not clear. However, in 2004, Clark classified it as a member of the larger group Pangalliformes, more closely related to chickens than to ducks, but not a member of the crown group that includes all modern Galliformes. Another specimen, PVPH-237, from the late Cretaceous Portslow Formation, Troniconiacin, about 90 MIA, in the Sierra de Portslow, Argentina, has also been suggested to be an early Galliform relative. This is a partial coracoid of a neornithine bird, which in its general shape and particularly the wide and deep attachment for the muscle joining the coracoid and the humerus bone resembles the more basal lineages of Galliformes. From the Mid-Eocene onwards, about 45 MIA or so, true Galliformes are known, and these completely replace their older relatives in the early Neogene. Since the earliest representatives of living Galliform families apparently belong to the Phasianidae, the youngest family of Galliformes, the other families of Galliformes must be at least of early Eocene origin but might even be as old as the late Cretaceous. The Ichnidoxin tristragulolithus gratioides is based on fossil eggshell fragments from the late Cretaceous Oldman Formation of southern Alberta, Canada, which are similar to Chachalaca eggs, but in the absence of bone material, their relationships cannot be determined except that they are apparently avian in origin. Modern genera of Phasianidae start appearing around the Oligo/Miocene boundary, roughly 25 to 20 MIA. It is not well known whether the living genera of the other, older, Galliform families originated around the same time or earlier, though at least in the New World quails, pre-Neogene forms seem to belong to genera that became entirely extinct later on. Description: they are chicken-like in appearance, with rounded bodies and blunt wings, and range in size from small at 15 cm to large at 120 cm. They are mainly terrestrial birds and their wings are short and rounded for short-distance flight. Galliformes are anisodactyly like passerines, but some of the adult males grow spurs that point backwards. Gallinaceous birds are arboreal or terrestrial animals. Many prefer not to fly, but instead walk and run for locomotion. They live 5 to 8 years in the wild and up to 30 years in captivity. They can be found worldwide and in a variety of habitats, including forests, deserts, and grasslands. They use visual displays and vocalizations for communication, courtship, fighting, territoriality, and brooding. They have diverse mating strategies. Some are monogamous, while others are polygamous or polygynandrous. Male courtship behavior includes elaborate visual displays of plumage. They breed seasonally in accordance with the climate and lay 3 to 16 eggs per year in nests built on the ground or in trees. Gallinaceous birds feed on a variety of plant and animal material, which may include fruits, seeds, leaves, shoots, flowers, tubers, roots, insects, snails, worms, lizards, snakes, small rodents, and eggs. These birds vary in size from the diminutive king quail long and weighing 28 to 40 grams to the largest extant Galliform species, the North American wild turkey, Meleagris gallobrevo, which may weigh as much as 14 kilograms and may exceed 120 centimeters, 47 in. The Galliform bird species with the largest wingspan and largest overall length, including a train of over 6 feet, is most likely the green pea fowl, Parvo muticus. Most Galliform genera are plump-bodied with thick necks and moderately long legs, with rounded and rather short wings. Grouse, pheasants, francolins, and partridges are typical in their outwardly corpulent silhouettes. Adult males of many Galliform birds have one to several sharp horny spurs on the back of each leg, which they use for fighting. In several lineages, pronounced sexual dimorphism occurs, and among each Galliform clade, the more epimorphic, advanced, lineages tend to be more sexually dimorphic. Flightlessness: while most Galliformes are rather reluctant flyers, truly flightless forms are utterly unknown among the living members of the order. Though they are often mischaracterized as weak flying, Galliformes are actually highly specialized for their particular flight style, bearing extremely powerful flight muscles, and some species are even migratory. Adult snowcocks are, however, in fact flightless, requiring gravity to launch, though juveniles can still fly relatively well. Nonetheless, a few birds outside the Galliform crown group did produce flightlessness. The genus Silviornis, a huge prehistorically extinct species of New Caledonia, was flightless, but as opposed to most other flightless birds like ratites or island rails, which become flightless due to arrested development of their flight apparatus and subsequently evolve to larger size, Silviornis seems to have become flightless simply due to its bulk, with a wing reduction following a consequence, not the reason for its flightlessness. The gigantic Australian Myhirongs, which may be closer to Galliformes than to Anseriformes as traditionally expected, achieved flightlessness more traditionally, strongly reducing their wings and keel. They were massive herbivorous birds, among the largest avian dinosaurs of all time. By contrast, the stone Galliformes gobelordix appears to have been more aerial than modern fowl, with a flight style more suited for gliding and soaring. Winter ecology: gallinaceous birds are well adapted to regions with cold winters. Their larger size, increased plumage, and lower activity levels help them to withstand the cold and conserve energy. Under such conditions, they are able to change their feeding strategy to that of a ruminant. This allows them to feed on and extract energy and nutrients from coarse, fibrous plant material, such as buds, twigs, and conifer needles. This provides a virtually unlimited source of accessible food and requires little energy to harvest. We'll be right back.